Okay, so here's another little fun problem. Since the division problem turned out to be so much fun, the multiplication and division one, here's another one that somebody pointed out to me. So I think it's, well, just, I don't know, let's take a look. So negative 20, well, that certainly equals negative 20. No arguments there, I think. Let's break up negative 20. I'm going to break it up on the left. I think I'm going to write that as 16 minus 36. Certainly, you still get negative 20 there. And on the right side, I'm going to write that as 25 minus 45. Okay, so now I'm going to rewrite things a little bit more. I'm going to rewrite 16 as 4 squared, and then I'm going to rewrite 36 as 4 times 9. On the right side, I'm going to rewrite 25 as just 5 squared, and then I'm going to rewrite 45 as 5 times 9. And all right, well, I think what I'm going to do now is I'm going to add to both sides. And the number that I'm going to add to both sides is I'm going to add 81 over 4. All right, so that's what we've got so far. Well, actually, I think we can factor this now a little bit. So we can do a couple things here, and you can check that this all works. So I'm going to leave the 4 squared alone. We can just rewrite 4 ninths pretty easily. I'm going to write that as 2 times 4 times 9 over 2. So I'm just breaking up the 4 over 9 here a little bit. And then I'm going to rewrite 81 over 4 as 9 over 2 squared. On the right side, I'm going to do the same thing. So we've got 5 squared. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to write this as 2 times 5 times 9 over 2, and then plus 9 over 2 squared. Okay, so we're just basically just the 2 and the 9 halves would cancel. Hey, give us back our 9 that we had up there. So, all right, so far so good. Well, the reason why we do this is this now factors nicely. This actually factors as 4 minus 9 over 2 times 4 minus 9 over 2. And the right side is going to factor as 5 minus 9 over 2 times 5 minus 9 over 2. All right, well, what that tells us is, well, we've got 4 minus 9 over 2 squared. That equals 5 minus 9 over 2 squared. And now, well, that means 4 minus 9 over 2 equals 5 minus 9 over 2. And, well, we could add 9 over 2 to both sides. So that tells us that 4 equals 5. And, well, if we subtract 4 from both sides, that now tells us that 0 equals 1. So, proof complete.